few people who have less experience, at least, of the German phenomenon of the Russian political party. Rousseau is on my left, Aglaya Bates-Corliss, who has actually written a book on the subject of her own time with the movement. I wonder if you could offer your thoughts as to both the day and perhaps the risk posed by Rousseau and the Rouge organization.
Mm-hmm. Yes, I think it is very tragic that young idealistic people are used and misused in such a way. I was a member of this organization at that time. It wasn't called Rousseau yet. It was it had many names. It was changing its names all the times. It was called European Labour Movement, and it was moving from the left wing to the right wing, back to the left wing, and back again. Well, I mean, we started out wanting to help to create a new world economic order, social justice, international justice, things like that. Yeah, and gradually we were turned around, and we were used for something else. Yeah, we were left-wing internationalists, and gradually the movement was turned into finally very, very, very conservative thing. Yeah, on the individual level, there was a gradual mental, psychological transformation. How was this achieved? I think one important method were the permanent and very intensive psycho sessions. So a young person wanted to do something to improve the world, yeah? But then what happened is we were bombarded. You have to change yourself, you have mother fears, you are weak, you are this, you are that, yeah? The habits were changed, the music was changed. You can't hear this music, this destroys you. You can't read this literature, this destroys you, yes. Yeah? I love Bertolt Brecht, yeah? He was considered as one of these devils, yeah? So, why did people go along with that? Why did we go along with so much bullshit? Yeah, there was, it was increasing, it was becoming worse and worse. Well, there were some things we could follow, we could understand, we thought were reasonable, like that there should be economical growth, there should be a new world economical order, there should be social justice, yeah? So, our way of thinking was, if La Rouge is right in this, then probably he's right in the West, yeah? But this was the big mistake. But there you see the workings of such a totalitarian group, because they were claiming to have the solution to everything. And this is typical of a totalitarian group of a destructive cult. Yeah, I mean, in a normal political party or a normal religious group or whatever you have, you join it, you do things because you agree with whatever you agree on, yeah? But you're not expected to go along with things which you do not understand, which you cannot judge, and so on. But this is typical for a destructive cult, yeah? And this is typical for a dictatorial leader, yeah, that these persons claim they can they have the last and final answer to everything, on psychology, even sexuality, whom you should, yeah, partnership, history, culture, music, art, science, energy problems, what have you.
Global warming.
Yeah. Today I think there is no question about it that this is a destructive cult which is transforming people. And one clear indication is that people are prohibited to study at universities. Yeah, and this alone, I think, is a crime. Yeah, to recruit young people who love nothing more than learning, studying. Yeah, and to tell them, you can do that only inside our organization. We create the universities. Yeah, we create the scientific environment. We do not want you to go out and find your knowledge somewhere else. Yeah. So I think that it's really important and urgent that this is being understood, and future sufferings to prevent future sufferings.
Thank you, Blanche.